Hello everyone. Today I want to talk to you about a new project I released a couple of days ago called xlivebg, and you can see the website right here. It's basically a system, a framework for creating live wallpapers for the X Window system. So instead of having a static image as your desktop background, what this allows you is to have something that moves, something animated, as a wallpaper. And the way it achieves that is by having the live wallpapers themselves basically be OpenGL programs, and providing a framework for those OpenGL programs to make it easy and simple and painless to write such live wallpapers for this system. The release of xlivebg comes with a few bundled live wallpapers, but the whole point is not for me to provide all the possible live wallpapers out there, but to make a framework for others to create live wallpaper with this. Basically, something similar to what X-Screensaver does, but for live wallpapers. And the thing is that to make it easy, everything that has to go on, every interaction with the X Window system, and including to how you figure out where to display your graphics, and also the OpenGL context creation, some configuration management, all of that plumbing is handled by xlivebg. And then the wallpapers themselves are very simple OpenGL programs that just draw to the display. They don't even need to know where they're drawing. They can just use OpenGL calls to draw their effect. And what I want to do today is just quickly go over the process of downloading and installing, building and installing xlivebg. And I just want to show you the few live wallpapers that are included with the first release. So basically, this is the website, the main project website, and you can find links for the documentation and the download. So let me just download the first release of xlivebg. I will download it right in the home directory. Okay, and also you can find a link to the manual, which provides detailed instructions on how to install and configure everything. So I'm going to open that in a tab as well. And also I have another tab with the GitHub page, with the source code and everything else. Yeah, so if you go to the manual, there is a section on installation, and basically, xlivebg is three main parts. It's the main executable, which handles all the interaction with the X Window system, etc. It's the bundled plugins under the plugins directory, and the graphical configuration tool called xlivebg GUI. So let's try to build that and see it in action. So I'm just decompressing xlivebg, going into the directory, and let me make this larger so you can see it easier. Okay, so in order to build xlivebg, it's very simple. You just have to run the configure script, and there are a number of dependencies. I'm listing them over here. So the main I made an effort to keep dependencies as low as possible so that you can build it easily. And it's quite compartmentalized, and you can just build the main xlivebg program and not the GUI if you want to do that. And you can also exclude plugins from the build. And basically, when I'm talking about plugins, I'm talking about the live wallpapers. Okay, so each live wallpaper is basically just a plugin for the xlivebg system. And the basic dependencies are just X11, OpenGL, libpng, libjpg, And there are two optional dependencies. If you want to build the GUI, you have to install the motif libraries. And if you want to build the video plugin, which is the video live wallpaper, you additionally have to install FFmpeg. So I have everything installed right here, but you can install everything on a Debian system by just running this apt command, and you're good to go. So yeah, let me, I just run configure. So the next step is to run make, and this will take a bit to build everything, build the main program and the wallpapers themselves and the UI. And everything's built. So now, in order to install it system-wide, let me bring up a root terminal. Yeah, so, okay, so in order to install, I'll just do make install all, to install all of the components. Otherwise, make install by itself just installs the main executable. So everything is installed now, and I can just start it and show you how it works. xlivebg uses user configuration files in the home directory of the user. You can modify them manually, or you can rely to the configuration program that I'm going to show you, which is the easy way to do it. So yeah, okay, so I have installed it, so I don't need to be in this directory anymore. Let's run it. Okay, so this is quite underwhelming, but this is just a default live wallpaper if you have not selected one. So by running xlivebg GUI, you get a bunch of configuration options here. And the list of available wallpapers is on the left. The left pane contains the global settings, which can be used by any wallpaper and are applicable to many of them. And the right part of the UI has to do with a specific wallpaper that we have selected. So for now, everything is empty. Let me just show you a couple of things that affect every wallpaper. So for instance, you can set the background color. So let me just set a background color here, which affects everything outside the area that the live wallpaper renders. And you can also use a gradient horizontally or vertically for the background color. And let me start by showing you the distort wallpaper. Okay, so the idea behind the distort wallpaper is that there is this wavy distortion effect happening all over the screen, which you can control. And also, this basically distorts the background image that you have selected. So by selecting the background image here, I can go to my BG directory and select, let's say, partial. Okay, so I have a background image right here. Let me minimize this. And The initial effect is just to have a distortion on the full screen. There are as soon as I selected the distort wallpaper, there are some settings from that wallpaper presented to the right side of the UI. So basically, I can adjust the amplitude of the waving or the frequency. So how short or wide are the waves? And there is another option as well. I can select an animation mask, so that's a second image that I have prepared, which is basically, actually let me show you this image. Yeah, so it's basically just an image where the top of the image is black and the bottom is white, and what this does is make the current wallpaper, the current live wallpaper, only affect part of the screen. So wherever this mask is white, that's where the waving happens, as you can see. And everything else is static. This is nice for effects like this distortion, where you want only the underwater part of the image to have this wavy effect and not affect anything else. So you can make a mask any way you like it. The other thing, which possibly Yeah, never mind. I'm going to show you another wallpaper. So this is one. Another potential wallpaper is the ripple wallpaper. And let me select a different one. Let's select bacteria and remove the mask. So what this does is basically track the mouse pointer and produce a subtle rippling effect wherever the mouse pointer moves. And there is another option, as you can see here, that allows you to have raindrops spawn from time to time on the desktop. So, yeah, each raindrop is going to create its own ripples, and then the mouse pointer itself also does this rippling effect. And another thing I wanted to show you while I'm on this wallpaper is how the xlivebg system handles aspect ratio of the background images. So basically right now I have the background image fit set to full, which means I'm seeing the whole image. So this background image I just selected is a 4x3 image, and the full fit mode just presents the image centered on the screen with bars on either side, and those bars are controlled by the background color and I don't know, background gradients. Okay. And there are other modes. One mode is called stretch, which does what you can imagine. Stretches the whole image to fit the screen, distorting it if necessary. And the other one, which is quite interesting, is crop. And what crop does, initially it seems very similar to full. So you can see it's the same result. But crop comes with further options where you can zoom the image in and out and have some part of the image being cropped. At the limit, you can zoom it to see only the image itself, which crops it, crops part of the image that are outside of the viewing area. And when you're in this mode, you can also use the panning controls to decide which part of the image you want to be visible. So I can do a vertical pan and have the image adjusted to where I want it. While it's zoomed like this, okay? So another thing that you can do, and let me go back to the distort for a second, because it's going to be easier to see it there, I think. Okay, so another thing that you can do is force a specific frame rate. So how this works is that each live wallpaper can inform the system what sort of drawing rate it needs, what sort of rendering rate it needs. And that's what the system does, that the xlivebg system calls the drawing function of its plugin, of the active plugin, at the frequency that it has requested. But the user, obviously, higher frame rates mean a higher CPU usage, right? So the user can decide to limit the frame rate to any arbitrary value by clicking this force checkbox and moving the slider. So if you move it quite low, you can see that the effect becomes choppy, and if you move it to a high value, it becomes smooth. So you can trade off between CPU usage and frame rate and the smoothness of the effect, irrespective of what the plugin itself wanted to use. So let me show you a couple more plugins. Actually, my favorite plugin is called Call Cycle, which is the one we started from at the beginning. And the thing is that a Call Cycle does not use this background image from the global settings. It has its own image field. And what it does is basically a palette cycling animation. So there are certain images that have been created to animate by changing colors in a color map. This was an effect used quite a lot in the older days in games and other graphics programs, where it wasn't necessarily the performance of the computer wasn't necessarily sufficient to do full screen animation, and you could just change a few palette entries, and with a very clever layout of the palette, and its usage in the image, you could produce very nice effects. And I'm going to show you my favorite image, which I'm actually using as my desktop background, which is this one. And you can see it's a very nice pixel art image, which produces this this beach waves effect, and it's actually very nice. If you can believe it, nothing is actually moving in this image. The only thing that changes is palette entries that are applied to a static picture. So this is very nice, and I have some instructions for where to get such images that you can use with this Live Wallpaper plugin. If you go to the manual, you can see under the color cycling animation wallpaper, it points you to a wiki page from an older project of mine called Call Cycle, where you can find links to many very nice images created by a person called Mark Ferrari, and which are also available on this Canvas Cycle website. So basically you can see all the images here and select one you like, and then you can download this image and use it. Obviously, yeah, okay, let's turn off the sound. You can download this image and use it as a live wallpaper with my xlivebg system. It's actually really nice. Yeah. Anyway, you can discover all that by yourself. Head over to that site and look it up. So, what else? I'm sorry. What else do we have here? Yeah, I have two more plugins to show you. One is pretty straightforward. It's called Stars. And what it does is basically a star field effect that also follows the position of the mouse. So you can move the mouse around and have this star field follow you around. You can change the color of the stars. You can change the how many stars there are. You can change their speed, their size. And also, if you don't like the... Actually, let me make that a bit slower. Okay, so if you don't like the movement effect, you can decrease the follow to zero, and the star field then remains static. And if you have mouse movement, you can also adjust how fast it snaps to where the mouse is. So the follow speed can be a large value, and you can see that you are almost controlling this in real time, like a first-person shooter or something. Or you can make it close to zero and have the star field slowly turn towards the mouse pointer. And the last plugin that I wanted to show you is called Video, and this is just the default state if you haven't selected a video. It does what it says on the tin. So basically, it just plays a video file on the wallpaper. And if I select a video clip that I have here, yeah. So yeah, if no other plugin does what you want, you still have the option to just find a video of something you like and put it on the wallpaper. And this loops forever. It just loops forever. It's not as efficient as the other plugins because it has to do the background decoding, and actually it's affected very much by the video itself. So if you try to put on your wallpapers something like a 4K video at 60 FPS, it's going to eat up a lot of your CPU time. But a somewhat low resolution clip at 25 or 30 FPS, it's okay. You can do that. You can leave it on the background. It's not using too many resources. And you can always adjust the frame rate with this slider if you wish, making the video choppier, but you know, faster on the, easier on the CPU usage. And yeah, basically, that's it. Go right ahead and download xlivebg, play around with it. By the way, another thing I haven't mentioned is that after you configure xlivebg the way you like it, in order for the configuration to stay and in order for the configuration to be saved, you have to click this save configuration button. Otherwise, it's only going to affect the current session. Next time you restart xlivebg, it's going to start from zero. And if you want to configure it manually, in the xlivebg source directory under documentation, you can find an example xlivebg.conf file, which is heavily commented, and you can see all the options and everything you can change, and you can just copy that to .config. Where is it? Oh, it's not here. Actually, I don't know where it saved it. Oh, etc. Okay, so it's obviously trying to save it on DC, and it fails because I don't have the necessary permissions. But if you actually create a configuration file under .config, where is it? Okay, so under .config xlivebg.conf, then it will attempt to save it there. So let me do that, show you how it's done. So basically, you need to copy that file to .config xlivebg.conf. You can edit it manually if you wish, but if you do this and then you restart xlivebg, okay, so the next time okay, so you configure it any way you like. Let's have it stretch or whatever. And then the next time you save configuration, it's going to attempt to save it at .config.xlivebg.conf, which is the current currently used configuration file. So saying yes, the settings are now saved. If I again kill xlivebg and restart it, you can see that my configuration options have been retained. Okay, so thanks for watching. I hope you try xlivebg, give it a go, and tell me if you like it, or if you can if you can think of any features that you would like to add. And also, I'm probably gonna make another video at some point, not too far in the future, where I'm gonna show you how to create live wallpapers with the xlivebg API, which is actually very simple. And there is an example live wallpaper in the documentation directory, which is basically the minimal OpenGL program that works with xlivebg. Yeah, so thank you, and let me know if you have any cool ideas for wallpapers or features. Report any bugs, and see you another time.